Hello, how are you? My name is Alejandro Sandoval, and this is the Solo Negocios video blog with a summary of the Solo Negocios Bulletin. And well, today will be monetary policy, specifically the Federal Reserve decision to raise its rate as it was expected. Now the new range is 1.75% to 2%. They manage their target rate in this range. And for example, in Mexico or other countries, they sell a fixed rate. Like for example, Mexico will have right now the 7.5% rate. Now, what's the deal with the issue? We already expected this this raise, but the deal was to read the bulletin press issued, and then also, well, read the lines between the comments of Jerome Powell, president of the Federal Reserve, when he made his press conference. Let's remember a little bit about the past. 2008, we have a Great Depression, or Great Recession in the US. The rate goes down to zero, or and the range is 0% or 0.25%. And then in 2014, they begin talking about eliminating liquidity offered by the Federal Reserve because the economy is growing. So since that moment, the volatility set includes the Federal Reserve's comments to damage, or obviously to indirectly damage, the Mexican peso, and it began depreciating since this, more or less this June 2014. Obviously, when Donald Trump won the presidency of the US in November 2016, it was again depreciated greatly, the Mexican peso, and then it has been moving around volatility from the 16 pesos per dollar to the 20 pesos, 21 pesos per dollar that is right now. Now, the issue here with the monetary stance is how fast they will be raising the rate or how slow they will do it. The first thought from the market is that it prefers to have it slowly because it's better for them to adapt the markets growing to a lesser impact of the less liquidity that is being provided by the Federal Reserve. But if it's faster, the rate, then the markets might get nervous and volatile. Well, the market expected for three increases this year, one in February, one in June, which already happened, and one in December. But that's a slower perspective. A faster perspective would imply a fourth hike, which will occur in October. Basically, what the wording of the bulletin press issued by the Federal Reserve and also the press conference of Jerome Powell is saying that the economy is growing suddenly or even greatly. Those words were not used in the past. And now the interpretation of the market is that the Federal Reserve will increase four times the rate this year, and then October and December will have interest rate hikes. What it implies for Mexico, basically, it implies that the spread between the Federal Reserve rate and the Mexican rate will be less than in the past. And this spread is basically the rate that the premium that we pay in Mexico to bring US dollars into our country in different ways to make investments, whether it's portfolio or direct investment. So this premium is being diminished when the rate increases, or when the rate begins increasing more and more. And obviously this is because Mexico has, as an emerging country or developing country, it's been weaker and it needs to provide this premium to the market. So the deal here is basically that the potential premium in the following months will be less. What will happen in the following days? Well, tomorrow we have the monetary political decision of the European Central Bank, and next week we'll have Banco de Mexico's decision. What will happen here? Well, basically, we will find a situation where the European Central Bank, which is not directly affecting Mexico but indirectly, will begin stating when they will cutting their purchases, their bond purchases that provide direct liquidity to their market. They will not move the rate. Now, next week, Banco de Mexico will have to evaluate the inflation rate more in the second part of May, which increased a little bit, and it seems that it increased given the depreciated peso, and how they will react to the obviously information of the first part of June and analyze if it was infected by this depreciation of the peso, and how it will be affecting the following months, inflation, this potential depreciation of the peso in the following days. If they perceive there's a great deal of risk to have more inflation, the rational way to react will be an increase in the rate in Mexico. But what's the risk with it? Well, increasing the rate will increase financing for companies and individuals, and it will slow the potential growth of the Mexican economy. So it's a double problem, because if you don't react, obviously you have a problem in first instance with the depreciation and potential inflation, but if you react, you cut the potential growth of the country. So this is the deal for Mexico and for the Banco de Mexico. And obviously in the following days, we will be seeing, between the surveys and the final decision of the Mexican presidential election, well, how the market will react to whatever the decision is. So this is the scenario right now with the monetary policy decision of the Federal Reserve, and we'll have more information tomorrow. Thank you for your attention. Good night.